framing pitches and getting strikes is measured in stats. And some of the best catchers in baseball help pitchers get up to 4 pitches a game in the strike column, according to the numbers, just by the way they receive and hold the glove. The Yankees catchers work on this, especially in spring training. And this week, we talk framing pitches behind the plate.
I like receiving. I like working on my receiving. I like getting my hands. I'm always trying to get better framing the baseball. And I think you're seeing that's a huge stat these days for catchers is how many balls can you turn into strikes.
In this new age, there are statistics that measure how many strikes catchers get simply by the way they frame a pitch. Top catchers improve the chances of a borderline pitch being called a strike roughly 20% of the time.
You know, if you can steal pitches here and there, it's great.
The league's understanding that it's the value of that is so great.
An average of 4 pitches a game may be questionable in the eyes of an umpire, and the catcher can make a big difference by how he holds a pitch in the strike zone and gets a strike call on a pitch that just may be a ball. The main things are to be quiet when receiving and no drifting with the glove.
And the changeup down and away.
In Joe Girardi's day, no such numbers existed, but those around the league knew its importance and also knew who were the best at it.
Well, you just knew who was really good at it. There was not a number assigned to it yet, or it wasn't quantified, or the one thing it probably didn't show up was in salaries back then, but you just knew certain guys were really, really good at it. The best that I saw was Charlie O'Brien. I thought he was tremendous. He also had really good guys that were around the plate that he was working with, but he used to steal so many strikes and hitters would get frustrated by it. But he was, you know, he really brought a lot of attention to it, you know, back in the 90s. But it's really, really important, and we want our catchers to work on it. You know, Tony's good about it. You got to make it fun because it is work and you don't want him to get bored with it or get frustrated with it. And there will be competitions and things that we do to liven it up.
Yankees pitching coach Larry Rothschild knows that framing a pitch is important, but does not agree with how the stats are measured and feels it is calculated inaccurately into numbers, so the stats can be deceiving.
I've gone through it, not so sure it's a good number because just in talking to a lot of people, you watch guys that are at the top of the league in framing. I'm not sure we're not missing something with it. Because I see a lot of guys that are really good catchers that aren't at that top. You know, if there's not a huge difference in the way that the numbers have said they frame balls, the other stuff probably is overriding whether they're good catchers or not. You know, if you throw a runner out, how does that equate to the outs that you possibly get framing a pitch? I don't know that, but it's certainly got to take on some kind of value because it's an out. So all those things come into play, and I'm not sure that the way that framing is analyzed today or the formulas are put together, I'm not so sure there's not something missing there. That, you know, it's great to have numbers to compare guys and things like that, but the important part of that is the numbers have to be right. I'm just not sure. You know, they may be, but in my mind, I'm watching guys that I think are really good catchers, and they're not necessarily at the top of that.